I just wanted to start off by saying, well, not saying, but making an apology. I have been very busy. I know that's always my excuse, but it's really true. I really appreciate all my fans and all my new subscribers, and I really do apologize for my absence. You know, I said in one of my other videos I must have bragged too quick because I jinxed myself, evidently. But, because time is always such a constraint for me, and I was having microphone troubles, and when something doesn't go my way after a couple of times, like if something tears up, like my mic wasn't working right, the Windows Movie Maker wasn't working right, and I just get so frustrated when it seems like I try and try and try and try, and there are constant obstacles that pop up. And that is kind of what I wanted to talk about in this Art Talk for Inspiration. This is episode number 2. It's kind of to pass on a little inspirational talk for those who are interested in getting started with an art career. And while I talk about a few things to help get you on the way, I filmed this inking video way back in March. I was already preparing for that Inktober. I've never done Inktober, but I would really like to do that this year. So with my other responsibilities, homeschooling my kids, they're out for summer, and I also teach at the local college, and that's how come I wanted to make this video. The number one piece of advice that I can give you, if you are wanting to get started with an art career, do not wait. I'm speaking to all of the middle-aged people out there. It's never too late to get started with an art career. But it's a little bit different for us than someone who wants to get started with an art career who have fewer responsibilities than what we do. But the best thing I can say, especially to you, to the younger folks out there, the teenagers and the people who are in their mid-20s, I'm also encouraging you to do not wait, to go ahead and get started, because when you get, I'm approaching my mid-40s. I'll be 44 in just a couple of weeks from at the time I made this video, which was in the middle of July 2017. Because the fewer responsibilities that you have, the easier it will be to get your art career off the ground because you have more time to spend with it. I have got, three teenagers, two puppies in the house. I homeschool my children teach medical office classes like billing and claim insurance forms and ICD-10 coding and just office stuff at the local college, and I also every now and then try to teach art classes over there. And so also, you know, trying to keep up with keeping the household running, you know, just with the typical stuff. And you know, I also go to CrossFit. I try to work CrossFit in. That's, for those who don't know what CrossFit is, that's like a gym. Because I try to maintain a healthy lifestyle. And that also takes a lot of time. So I've got a lot of responsibilities. Not saying that young people don't have responsibilities. I know y'all do too. But I'm just saying. The way I was doing so well there for a while when I first got started, even I still have not been able to make a career out of my art because of all the responsibilities that I have now as a woman who is approaching 44 years old. But when my responsibilities were not as hard to get accomplished on a daily basis, I started on eBay, and right now you don't have to have a store on eBay, and they allow 50 free listings a month. You don't have to pay to list it, you know, and it's like they only take a like a 10% cut or something like that if it sells, but you get 50 free listings a month, and I recommend anybody to take advantage of that. That was where I always got so many looks on eBay. But a word of caution, anytime you're doing something like that and you're trying to get your art career off the ground, you cannot stop creating because you will get followers. It takes time, but when you get a fan base, and then you just all of a sudden, because you've got too many responsibilities and you have to put your art on the side, people will stop following you. I'm speaking from experience. I've got some who are loyal and still continue to follow me, but it's just harder to keep your fan base satisfied when you've got too many responsibilities. And depending on the area where you live, if you don't want to do anything online and just want to keep it local, depending on where you live, check at your, like, your local Chamber of Commerce and see if there are any local art and craft shows that you can get into. All of the local people that I'm friends with, they like to see me in those little festivals and stuff because they attend those, you know, regularly. And I always do pretty good, you know, when I attend a local art and craft fair. This has always been a hard one for me. But if you want to get your art career off the ground, you're going to have to be involved in social media. If it wasn't for the internet, and eBay and Etsy and some of the other places that are online, you know, especially Facebook, if I didn't have a fan page set up on Facebook, I wouldn't have sold as many art pieces as I have if I hadn't been involved with social media. It's just I can't get too involved with social media, you know, because of the responsibilities that I have. So that's always, I'm always coming back to that, you know, just take time every day to get a little bit of art done if you're wanting, but it's never too late to try to get your art career started. You know, if you're ready for a career change, you have to put the work into it, because I speak from experience, it has never fallen in to my lap. Because there will be periods of 6 months, 4 to 6 months, that I don't have time to create because of my responsibilities. So don't wait. The fewer responsibilities you have, the easier it will be. And if you want a website, that Wix.com, W-I-X, that's a free website where you can display your art and stuff, and I would take advantage of that. Sometimes I've seen that advertisement on YouTube, and for a free website, it really is free if you don't, you know, like put a shopping cart or anything, but it's just a way to display your art. But you do have to start somewhere. If you do not create art and put it online for sale or try to sell it locally in your area, you will never be able to have an art career. You actually have to put the work into it. But I am also realistic. I have a part-time job, like I said, at the local college, teaching college classes. So I've not been able to be a full-time artist yet. So I still have a part-time job, you know, because it's a stable income, and there's nothing wrong with that. I love whenever I get my responsibilities done. I love to create something. But that's all I wanted to talk about in this video. So I will catch y'all next time. And thanks for stopping by. And if you haven't already subscribed, I would love for you to, but you don't have to if you don't want to. So thanks again.